Hello, I am Emma. I'm your virtual presenter on behalf of Edgely's Cultivation, and thank you for watching our carbon farming hemp seed business promotion video. In this short presentation, we are explaining an industrial hemp seeds business model, which we believe can and will absolutely propel South Africa's economical development and recovery at the highest possible rate and with a greater economical gain than can be derived from any other industry, utilizing cannabis in any manner for at least the next 5 to 7 years. Our enterprise milestones regarding hemp seeds as a focus of development in business are outlined for the next 3 to 5 years. As explained before, our business models are tailored and structured to accommodate a future of 50 years to come. We aim to effectively turn the African continent into the main production and manufacturing hub for 80-90% of the global value supply chain in the next 15 years. Utilizing industrial hemp of the seed-focused instead of fiber-focused varieties, we are starting by effectively establishing sustainable, profit-generating carbon farming hemp seeds businesses in Southern Africa. Edgely's Cultivation is registered with the European Commission as an official third-party operator in the plants category. We are soon in line with all EU traces system requirements. We are going to give you key knowledge and information required for your hemp business plan formation and implementation. So we hope that you take the time to listen and learn carefully from this video. The Edgely's Cultivation South African National Hemp Business Model has 4 sectors, and they are: Number 1, carbon credits. Number 2, hemp seeds. Number 3, hemp flour. Number 4, hemp biomass. We love all South Africans, and in order to ensure every South African can understand how hemp agriculture and economical development genuinely works, how to start it, how to apply it, and how much money to make from it, is one of our primary ethos goals. This short video is to promote South African hemp farming. Hit the like and subscribe button. Let's start with the free money first. This is the smallest income sector out of the 4 industrial hemp agricultural income sectors, and it is called carbon credits. Corporate organizations who still use fossil fuels, paraffin, petroleum, PPM diesel, or pumped black oil are slow in the transition phase to use hemp as a constructive material. During this intense global research and reform process, they are willing to pay farmers worldwide for growing industrial hemp. Hemp is the best carbon sink, and the more hemp is cultivated, the better earth will become again. 1 ton of industrial hemp cultivated from seed to harvest will extract approximately 1.6 tons of carbon dioxide from the air. The hemp plant stores the carbon permanently inside itself, hence its textile strength and infrastructural building capacity. And amazingly enough, while being an atmospherical carbon sink, hemp will also remediate the soil in a beautifully holistic manner. Organic, friendly carbon producer, industrial hemp. Good value for humanity. So your money income is linked to the size of your grow and can be calculated very easily. For instance, 10 hectares of land can yield approximately 80 to 220 tons of total industrial hemp biomass under either dry land or normal irrigation standards. So that's 128 to 352 tons of carbon dioxide, which can be removed from the air, and because industrial hemp has a life cycle of approximately 120 days from seed to harvest, this can be done up to 3 times per year. Farmers get paid around 8 euros for every ton of carbon dioxide extracted from the air, so that's between 18,000 and 50,000 South African rand for every 10 hectares cultivated, which can be seen as free money 3 times a year for those who want to, although the population should by obvious default already increase its hemp agricultural activities, and not just for the sake of making money too easily. But yes, the world wants you to start cultivating industrial hemp so much you've hit sequestered remuneration just for selecting this crop species to cultivate. We say this because one can also work the math back and say that hemp farmers will be paid around 12.8 euros for every ton of industrial hemp cultivated. Depending on how much annual rainfall you have, industrial hemp can be sown for free by hand, and every 100 hectares harvested can yield an additional 365,000 rand. This is just simply outstanding. This is what you can call an income which comes with a new age. The earth needs our help. Industrial hemp can fix 90% of the bad human activity which has been done, and large corporations are willing to pay you for your help. Now that you slightly grasp the basics of carbon sequestration, we move deeper into understanding the parameters of our current industry-level standards and implementation methodologies. South Africa, absolutely, must design and build its own national hemp seed delivery system, starting with seed-focused varieties, and focus on food security as a means to an end, when utilizing industrial hemp economically for the short term. Edgeley's cultivation stands by the fact that the current industrial hemp industry in South Africa should be solely backed for seed production and seed multiplication for the next 5 to 7 years. The reason is that South Africa does not have an infrastructure set up to undertake the textiles and construction industry. We lack the means to implement and support systems for first and second stage processing and up to third transformation manufacturing. Out of the main three raw variable materials harvested from any single industrial hemp crop, namely the hemp seeds, hemp flour and hemp bales, the stalks and leaves, the hemp seeds is our second sector, and this industry type is what you can make money with, using industrial hemp, in South Africa right now. We have developed a model which makes the entire cultivation operation run profitably and sustainably just off the seeds alone. The seeds are an excellent source of nutrition for all living creatures and is also a complete source of protein as it contains all of the 20 known amino acids, including the 9 essentials, which our bodies do not produce on their own. It also has the correct 3-to-1 fatty acid ratio for omega-3 and 6. The current market price in South Africa for a single kilogram of hemp seeds in the Dahold form is about 800 rand. A seed production-focused farmer needs 45 kilograms of certified hemp seed to effectively plant a single hectare of industrial hemp using a seed-focused variety. Certified seed costs 550 rand per kilogram. A single hectare can yield between 800 kilograms and 2.2 tons of hemp seeds, cultivated either under dry land conditions or normal irrigation standards. In some cases, well-prepared land, good nutrient feeding ratios, and on-point scheduled water feeding can push yield results above 4 tons of hemp seed per hectare. Hemp seed dehulling machines cost about $25,000 each and can process about 1.5 ton of hemp seed per hour. 40% of the whole hemp seed weight is its outer shell. Only 60% of the total hemp seed's weight is the nutritious hemp hearts or hemp kernels. A good seeds grading machine can grade about 4 tons of hemp kernels per hour with an accuracy above 99%. This means you can effectively remove all of the green, brown and black seed films or membranes, which covers the white kernel inside the shell. These machines cost about $40,000 each. A good seeds processing and manufacturing company has a good facility with all the relevant machinery and equipment and right layout. You should have the following. 1. Good inner working warehouse with pragmatic layout. 2. Well-positioned seeds reception intake pit. 3. Submerged intake feeder hoppers. 4. Seeds dryer, the continuous flow type. 5. Whole hemp seeds color sorter grading machine. 6. Hemp seed dehulling machines. 7. Hemp kernel color sorter grading machine. 8. Hemp seed cold presses. 9. Oil refinery equipment. 11. Bottling machines. 12. Bagging machines. 13. Labeling machines. 14. Stitching machines. 15. Trucks and vans. 16. Managers and staff. So without going into too much deep math and finance operation explanation, it's easier for you now to understand that a 1,000-hectare seed-focused operation can give you a near billion rand in return based on just seed sales alone. The best food-based products to produce from hemp seed farming right now is hemp hearts, hemp milk, hemp flour, hemp dietary fiber, and hemp food oils. The African continent would appreciate more suppliers of affordable and safely produced fresh and organic hemp seed foods. Mineral, oil, and gas mining companies focused on carbon credits, on the other hand, should use only seed-focused industrial hemp varieties to produce seed which can go for biodiesel from these phytoremediation projects instead of the food markets, since they should contain trace amounts of heavy metals and other unwanted elements. And although fiber varieties will produce more hemp, meaning these varieties will perform better for carbon sequestration than seed-focused varieties, we do need that green diesel more. Hempcrete with high amounts of heavy metals will also degrade slowly over time as the heavy metals try to escape the dryingcrete blocks, causing cracks and breakages. Fiber-focused varieties used for phytoremediation purposes should be used instead for substances like graphene. So, moving along. When it comes to the byproducts harvested, you will now begin to understand that from any single cultivated industrial hemp crop, unless otherwise specified, you will yield the following three raw variable materials. 1. Hemp seeds. The highly nutritious, oil-rich, and healthy-to-eat seeds can go for either the food or energy industry. 2. Hemp flower, high CBD rich inflorescence biomass, which can go for the medical industry, food industry, cosmetics, and renewable energies. 3. Hemp biomass, the carbon rich and nutritious baleable hemp plant stalks and leaves, which can go for building materials or animal feed pellets. An entire hemp enterprise can successfully run its whole hemp operation profitably and sustainably by utilizing just the seeds commercially. In a loving, collaborative society, the enterprise would use the hemp seeds to make money and the revenue from making medicine and animal food, for example, out of the rest of the hemp-harvested materials would be seen as an added bonus. A business dynamic like this could greatly reduce the overall construction and medication cost of a developing country's population. This, in turn, would exponentially increase our overall living standards. And now, we have reached the end of this video, and we hope that you can share our vision for the future of all Africans. This is how we aim to implement our Proudly South African Evolve Health Sustainably program initiative. We start somewhere smart, and we end somewhere smart. The key to any empire's longevity lies in the time and patience it takes in laying down its foundation setting. Thank you again for watching this video, and we hope that you stay tuned for more. Until next time, take care and goodbye.